Greetings. Today I'm going to show you how to make oats milk. Oats milk is a non-dairy milk and it tastes good with tea and coffee. I have been consuming tea and coffee made with the oats milk for the last 2 months now. I've been buying oats milk from the market from several companies, and each carton at each tetra pack of oats milk costs around more than between 300 and 400 rupees. It lasts for about a week or so, but I thought that I would like to make my own oats milk. I've seen a few recipes online and I've made it once successfully, and today is my second attempt at making oats milk. I'm going to show you the process from beginning to end. Hi, my name is Dr. A.K. Venkatachalam. I am an orthopedic surgeon in Chennai, India. These days, because of the pandemic, I am staying at home and seeing very few patients, but offering online consultations. If you wish to seek an online consultation, you can visit my website www.orthobiologicsurgeryindia.com. I've got a lot of videos over there. You can find more of my cooking videos and do-it-yourself videos from my YouTube channel, Madras Joint Replacement Center, MJRC. Of late, I'm uploading health-friendly diets. Today, I've made a video on cauliflower rice, and this is one on keto milk or non-dairy milk. The benefits are great, and I'll see you again. I'm going to now show you how to prepare keto milk or oats milk from beginning to end. So, to make oats, you need good quality oats. I got this oats in the market here. It's called Saffola oats, and they also gave me a free packet of 400 grams with it. It is 100% natural and it is whole cut oats. It doesn't have any sugar in its ingredients. You can see the nutritional information of this packet of oats over here. It has per 100 grams 66.8 grams of carbohydrate, which is more than the requirement for per day. Ideally it should be about 50 grams, so this has got slightly more, and per serving it gives you 21.4. so 100 grams or 2 cups will give you 21.4 grams of carbohydrate. Total sugar is 0.5 and there is no added sugar. The cost of it is, for a kg, it costs around only 139 rupees. I have taken 2 cups of this oats and soaked it here. I used oats of this size. I'm going to show you how to pour it. So I took 2 cups like this. This cup will be approximately 200 ml. And I've used 2 cups. After soaking, it has come to so much. I will be pour. If I need to make oats starting from the beginning, I'll have to add 2 such cups and add some water in it. Water has been added, and this oats has been soaking for about more than an hour now. I'm going to rinse it and then prepare to grind it. Oats milk can be sometimes slimy, and so if your brand of oats is too slimy, it's better to soak it overnight to get rid of the slime. Now I'm going to rinse it. I've taken a sieve and I'm going to pour this soaked oats in the sieve. And squeeze it until all the water is gone. There it is. And I'm going to rinse this oats now. Now I'm going to grind this oats which has been rinsed. I'm going to pour the whole contents of this into the mixer grinder jar here. To this quantity of oats, which is about 2 cups, I am going to add 800 ml of cooled water. I had previously kept a bottle of water in the fridge, and it has been there for some time, and you can see that it is quite cool. I am going to pour this in to the blender jar. And not being happy with that, I am going to add a few cubes of ice. The reason for doing this is that oats has got a lot of sliminess. Adding cold water and ice will help to remove the slime content from oats. Cover the blender jar with the lid, and then we are going to grind it now. Now the oats has been blended in this blender jar. This is the consistency. Round of blending in the jar, and now I'm going to pour this through a sieve into a container like that. Before pouring it, I'm going to place a cloth like this. It's a handkerchief, but you can get a filter cloth. And you can pour the oats in it like this. After everything has been poured, we can bunch up this cloth to prevent any sediments leaking through, and squeeze this cloth. So you see all the liquid milk is coming through without any residue from the oats going into the container, and there will be very little residue. And that's the residue we have, and here we have good oats milk. I have not added any preservative, no flavor, no sweetening agent, nothing. I'm not just going to pour it into a bottle and I'm going to store it in the fridge. Now I'm going to pour this milk into a glass jar, and there we have good quality oats milk. So from about 100 grams of oats, I've got this amount of oats milk. I can heat it if I want to, but since I've already got some open oats milk, I'm just going to keep it like this in the fridge. It will stay like this without spoiling in the fridge for about 2 to 3 days, within which we have to consume it.